South Australia has become the focus of the carbon tax hard sell, with the climate change minister visiting Whyalla. The tour has sparked criticism that the government is meeting the winners but shunning the losers.
Whyalla has escaped the carbon tax largely unscathed, thanks to a generous compensation package offered to OneSteel. Nevertheless, the climate change minister has toured the steelmaking town.
The government recognises we need to be going to talking to people, reassuring them that, you know, there is a good future. There's a positive future for people.
Positive for Whyalla, perhaps, but not other regional centres such as Lee Creek, which faces the certain closure of its coal mine. Mr Combe has no plans to visit there anytime soon, but rejected suggestions he's only preaching to the converted.
I'll be in Adelaide over the course of the next week or two as well, and talking to people there.
Suggestions the Greens are pulling the strings appear to be eating away at the government. Greg Combe keen to point out Labor is running the show.
I don't agree with the Greens on many things. We have a number of differences with the Greens.
But a greater foe for the government is Tony Abbott. He wants an election and says if he wins and Labor and the Greens don't budge on the carbon tax, he'll push for a double disillusion election.
I'm going to fight it in the parliament. I will fight it in the electorate. And if it gets through, I will rescind it.
The government says that would wash away business certainty.
What could wreck confidence in our economy more than an opposition leader running around saying he doesn't want just one election, he wants two elections?
The opposition's also saying the carbon tax will add an extra $4 million onto the yearly running costs of the new RAR.
It is a cancerous tax, and it is going to eat away at the South Australian government's ability to provide health services.
But the federal government rejects that, saying the new hospital will use 40% less power than the existing one. Adam Todd, 10 News.